Surely we must see it.
Come on, Purple Emperor.
Bread!
Got one here!
Bread!
Bread! Bread! Bread! Bread!
Go!
Can we have the net, please?
She's got the small white.
Comma. Yes, it's Skipper. Quickly.
There you go. Little white letter hair streak.
Permanent Emperor, go!
Painted lady.
Yeah, I'm not worried. We've got Grey Little.
It's a beautiful morning, bright sunshine here this morning, and as I say, I just drove down to have a look at the harbour, and it's absolutely picturesque. It's what makes Sussex, Sussex, but it's very near to the border with our friends in Hampshire, and it's that sort of rivalry today that has a serious message behind it. Now, just before we go into the competition, let's talk to an old friend of the programme, Dan Danaher. Good morning, Dan.
Good morning, Simon. Good to see you.
Come a bit closer, because you're a tall gentleman. Now, we spoke to you a few years ago about butterfly conservation, and something that started in Sussex has now gone UK-wide, hasn't it?
That's right. Well, we're really excited about that whole thing. Butterfly conservation is really, really pushing for people to get involved in counting butterflies this year, and this is quite a good way of doing it.
And there's a serious message behind it, isn't there? Because, I mean, how are our butterfly stocks, if I can use that phrase, how are they doing?
Well, you think about it, we've had some incredibly bad weather over the last couple of years, and last year was almost a washout for most butterflies. This sunny period is a real boost, and we're really, really excited about that. And so when we did the butterfly count last year, we saw really, really poor results, but we just can't believe what we might expect to see this year.
Let battle commence, gentlemen!
Hooray! 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 Hooray!
Inside,
we're
children.
Well, Debbie, what
have you got
for this
there?
Yeah,
small
copper.
There's
small
skipper
there.
What's
that?
Oh, yeah,
meadow brown.
Yes. Meadow brown.
Gatekeeper.
Are we sure that's not a
gatekeeper?
Gatekeeper. We've got gatekeepers. Loads of gatekeepers.
What's a large
skipper?
Where's the gatekeeper?
Gatekeeper. Let Debbie, show Debbie a gatekeeper.
Yeah. There, what?
There we go.
Yeah.
There we go.
Yeah.
Look, see with its wings open.
Yeah.
Orange.
Right,
there's a small skipper. That's a small skipper there.
And
this one's a small skipper.
Yeah.
Where's the large skipper?
It was out on the grass over there. Good.
We'll get others.
Further out.
Thank you, Andrew.
But you put the marble white in there.
There's the large skipper sitting on a bit of grass.
How many species now?
Where?
Purple Hairstreak!
No!
Okay, wait for it to move again.
Hang on.
Keep pointing where it is. Debbie's got to see it.
Just paying.
Oh, no, above us here. That's a
hairstreak. No, that's a vapor mop.
Is that
doesn't count.
So, was that purple hairstreak we saw? Was that a vapor?
Yeah, but let's just get this large skipper.
Oh, it's a swim.
Just move. Just see that skipper there buzzing about through the back?
We've got small talk, small copper, small skipper, marbled white, meadow brown, large skipper,
gatekeeper.
This is the beast. This is the beast that we came all this way for. This spot is rewarded greatly, Neil. It's a good spot.
The non-traditional butterfly collecting way. Look at that.
Oh. Yay. Okay.
Oh, not the second one.
Crap.
Oh, there's another
Go down to the Essex skipper quickly, quickly, quick.
You got the small white, didn't you?
Yeah, I saw that, yeah.
Learned some lessons last year, you see, learned some lessons. We got a bit complacent, a little bit cocky, and we nearly got beaten. We kind of like started relaxing and just kind of going to pubs and stuff like that. But we've just every little opportunity. So have we got black on the underside of the antenna?
No, I've got my glasses on, Nick.
Oh, I've heard some excuses. Sorry. So that is an Essex skipper. So we've had small skipper and Essex skipper now.
We need to get onto the A31. There are a couple of ways to do it, I believe. Bloody blue is critical. Yeah, keep your eyes peeled over the hedgerows and see the power of the view.
Use binoculars to scan those leaves. You're looking for a small, dark chocolate brown triangle.
I've got binoculars.
Well, like Toblerone.
Yeah.
Little segments of Toblerone sitting up on those leaves.
Yeah, Neil, can you just
say that again,
Okay. Have a look, the males will be sitting right up on the edges of the elm trees, looking outwards. Just seen a white letter hair streak go through there.
It's really not comfortable.
It's an arboreal species, it lives at the top of trees and elm trees. Elm is its food plant, and the whole colony will actually persist around a little clump of elms. But of course, with Dutch elm disease in the last couple of decades, a huge reduction in the elm stock in this country, and as a result of that, the butterfly has been in trouble.
We are on 13 species. At the moment, we're in a particularly unglamorous situation. I was hoping to beat you in some beautiful piece of Hampshire countryside, but we're actually next to a dual carriageway by a roundabout, desperately looking at some scruffy little elm trees on the off chance of seeing a beautiful little butterfly that's been described as a miniature slice out of a Toblerone. It's a little white letter hair streak. It's a very beautiful butterfly. I'm actually racing as we speak, so every time I twitch, I do apologise. It's quite heated. But it's this wonderful juxtaposition between the what would normally be considered
a... I'm here to check that nobody's cheating. So they'll shout, I'll run and look as well and just make sure. But we're doing really well, we're up to 14 species already.
Early in the day and late in the day, they become very active. They squabble a lot. They'll attack each other, and they'll attack all other aerial insects, bees, things like that. They'll chase after them. So it's quite a pugnacious and aggressive little beast.
They've got the small heath there. Do you want to?
Okay,
have you got it
go
in the
and get
net?
It.
Bring it here.
Patrick, we've just seen silver studded blue. That was quite a remarkable find, wasn't it?
We pulled up, and there it was, right by the roadside, and I thought it was common blue. You went silver studded, and you were right, so.
Yeah. They've got the small heath there. Do you want
to? Okay,
have you got it
go
in
and
the
get
net?
It.
Even
bring it here.
The experts find it difficult sometimes to differentiate common species instantly, don't
yeah.
they?
And yeah, yeah.
So for everyone, all us ordinary mortals who go out looking at butterflies, you know, there's no sort of terrible disgrace in not being able to instantly identify your butterfly. You know, it sometimes takes a bit of time.
Very big spots. It's got black border as well, doesn't it?
Yeah,
black border. Wow, what's that doing on a roadside bird?
I don't know, but there you are.
Sorry.
What?
Okay.
Yeah. Are we getting back in the vehicles now?
Neil, we got one here.
Are
we getting back in the vehicle?
Was that the key speed?
What are you really looking forward to seeing today? Is there a special butterfly for you? You want
well,
to
it's the purple emperor because I didn't see one last summer.
Back in.
You know, just that iridescent purple. Obvious. It's an obvious choice.
And it's been
it?
A remarkable year, hasn't it?
Purple incredible. Emperor. We've had 100 individuals seen in Firmin Woods in Northamptonshire, which is sort of like the great Hallucson days of the past, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's like
yeah.
sort of well, it better look, than ever.
It looks like butterflies are making a way back. Now, I understand we've got to go
I'm
now.
Excited.
We've got to
excited.
Go. We're
let's
get on
go
the road.
The
bye bye now.
Of
work
just for 2 points where they could go somewhere else and get two species. Yeah, easily. Like we did, we just got seven.
You and you said one brace, two tortoise shells.
Either one of the purples.
Preferably both. Come on, this has got to be the spot, hasn't it?
small triangular butterfly you see flitting around. Hopefully, if it moves.
Rarely come down.
The wind won't bother it, it's such a strong flyer, but it's other purple emperors being around, that's what'll make it mad. And if there's no reason for them to fight, then they'll sit and do nothing.
I'm not worried, we've got grayling. Have they got grayling?
There's a purple emperor!
What?
Just come down the side!
No! I'm looking up!
That's not good. Ever since I plucked those very first large white caterpillars from my mum's nasturtiums when I must have been, I don't know, six or seven, and watched them magically transform from this sort of little hungry caterpillar into this twitching chrysalis and then into a butterfly. It doesn't matter if it's a cabbage white, a large white. It doesn't matter at all because the magic's still there. Just watching that transformation. That's
Do you think
it.
It's a part of it? A part of it's about nostalgia then for you.
I've got memories of, you know, rides and downs on the Isle of Wight, absolutely crawling with butterflies, but not just all of the same species, but a real diversity.
Yeah, no,
and,
I think
and they do exist. Yeah. These patches, but they're not as frequent as they used to be.
20 feet from the top.
Okay. Well, the bit that sticks out.
Yeah, so
to the right.
You see the bit that sticks out on the left-hand side?
Yeah.
It's go up diagonally from there into... Well, that's where I think it landed.
Last year was a tremendously bad year, without a doubt. Probably the worst year for butterflies ever.
And now we've got it's a butterfly summer, let's face it. Like, this is what butterflies need. It's the peak of the flight period for a lot of species. Well, not peak of flight, but there's more species on the wing about now. And, of course, when it's nice and dry and sunny, that's when you get the butterfly activity. They can complete their life cycle.
And totally unexpected as well, because we had such a cold spring.
Yeah.
And the spring was one which held a lot of stuff in chrysalises for a long time, but when they came out, did they come out?
That's right, and of course, after a cold winter, I think there's also something in that. The fact we've had proper seasons, proper cold winter, where everything can.
I think they just said purple emperor, Nick.
Where?
Yeah. There's a lot of butterfly conservation people here today, but you're an Isle of Wight Wildlife Trust CEO.
Yep.
What is it about an event like this that makes you want to support us?
We're good partners. We work with BC a lot, you know, we've got a lot of common aims. We care about butterflies as well.
Yes.
We do all wildlife, but we have a lot of nature reserves that are great for butterflies. And we do a lot of partnership working with butterfly conservation.
Do you think that partnership's an important part of conservation?
Absolutely. There's more than enough work to do for all of us. We worked together recently on the State of Nature report,
yes.
And that showed that, you know, 60% of species are declining. Butterflies aren't doing so well in many places. So we should join up. You know, we have land.
Here we go, 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 go,
go, go, go, go, go,
go, go. Yeah, the same one that we saw go that way earlier.
In this tree, there is a purple emperor. A lot of people have seen them, but you haven't seen it, have you?
I haven't seen it, no. It keeps being a bit elusive.
Yeah.
This happened last year as well, we were promised purple emperor. We didn't see one of them either.
I want to see it properly.
It's almost like the old days when the summer was summer.
Yeah.
When we were kids,
yeah.
It was always hot. I just remember it always being.
That thing, that big green thing, that's hiding our prize, ports more invertebrates, more creepy crawlies, more insect species than any other British tree. Every twig, every branch is growing against all these stresses, gravity, wind, all these things. That's an engineering miracle as well. That's biomechanics in action right there.
I mean, look how big it is.
Yeah, big enough to hide a great big purple emperor.
Or two.
Jeremy, whereabouts is it?
Coming round.
Purple emperor, go, go!
Where? Purple emperor, purple! Oh, your faces.
You.
There! Let's go! Let's go! Let's go!
Yes. Yeah, things are beginning to close up finally. Chalkhill blues are not as late as just about everything we can see. Even the emperor was late, having to end the first week of July.
That's it, I'm going home now. I've probably not seen one of these since I was 18. flicking its rim. It's teasing us. We're seeing a little glimpse of purple. No, there's a bit of purple on it.
Is there?
Yeah, it's purple, definitely.
You get that sort of vague feeling, I don't really care who wins now.
Yeah, I don't. I don't care. I really don't care. I mean, we had that.
Bob, are you happy now?
Posing for it.
Yeah. First purple emperor that's close off and twice around the wood.
I'm Nick Baker, and I'm a naturalist and a lover of big purple butterflies.
Having missed that other one as well.
Yeah. So Martin, you know, you're a busy man. Why are you here today?
Well, this is combining a really nice day out of the office to see some lovely butterflies. But the whole race today is important about raising awareness about the decline of butterflies. Last year was the worst year ever on record for butterflies. Many species were in real trouble, highly threatened. So what we're trying to do is just use the race as a way of getting people interested in butterflies, getting them to look around and see what's there, what they can see, and particularly join us with the big butterfly count. Which, what we do is we piece that together and we really want it right across the UK. So we want the far parts of Scotland, the far west, the far east. We want information from everywhere, and then we can really see whether what the UK population is doing.
Right, so that's one side of things, I think. Nigel, you're chair at Sussex Butterfly Conservation.
That's right.
And you describe yourself as a layman. I don't know, I necessarily agree with that, but what does it mean for you personally when you're doing this stuff?
I think it's the thrill of the hunt. Not the hunt in the sense you're going to kill anything, but the hunt that you're going to find out about it, you're going to understand its habits, you're going to learn how it lives. Actually getting close to one of these butterflies and seeing them, it's a very emotional experience.
Emotional, I think that's right. Would you agree with that, Mark?
Oh yeah, absolutely. Real.
That there is the caterpillar of a comma butterfly. As you can see, he's literally just hatched. The egg is on the tip of the leaf there. You can just see the empty, shiny little egg there. And the caterpillar's just there chewing away. That's the hole in the leaf.
I've excelled myself. I'm feeling
that's a comma.
Slightly smug. Try not to make too much of it because obviously the company is rather advanced. So I'm just going to casually go, oh yeah, that's a comma.
But I think it's not just these sort of blockbuster butterflies that I enjoy, but getting out, seeing the silver-sided blues perhaps are quite rare, but even the commoner ones, the tortoiseshells, the peacocks, things flying around your garden.
Look, we saw a red admiral, didn't we, just back there?
Yeah.
Most beautiful, pristine red admiral. Yeah. My favourite butterfly.
Is it?
I would have thought that throughout a whole season you're going to be able to get 30 or more species here.
That's quite remarkable.
Almost certainly. It's got some of the butterfly royalty here. We've got Purple Emperor, Silver Wash Fritillary, White Admiral, Purple Hair Streak. So it's a good wood, well managed, lovely mix of deciduous trees. There's a little bit of conifer spread around as well, but nice wide rides as well with sort of nice margins, floristically rich margins.
Yeah.
So there's plenty going on in all of the open spaces in the wood here.
Neil, you're really, I was going to say secret weapon, but there's nothing secret about you, Neil. You're so pumped, aren't you? You're so full of energy. And it's a lot of, if we win this today, it's down to you because you're taking us to the right places. Is it coming together the way you think you wanted it to?
Apart from the fact that we dipped out on White Letter Hair Streak, it's pretty much going to plan.
Yeah.
So it took a little bit longer than I hoped for to find the Purple Emperor, but that's one we just could not miss.
No.
There's
a lot of reputation on that, isn't there, really?
Of course, yes, particularly with the two Purple Emperor experts.
So what's on your list now? We said dark green fritillary, maybe cloudy yellow if we're lucky.
Yes.
But
Painted Lady is another one, another migratory species, and Painted Ladies have been arriving in the country over the last month or so, only in relatively low numbers, but I do think that we've got a chance of picking up either a Clouded Yellow or a Painted Lady.
Dark green fritillary.
charging. We're going to go back for white letter.
White letter history.
White letter history.
So where are we looking?
Where?
Up high.
Yeah, but up high.
On what?
This way.
It's not turning around, is it?
Have a look at the iPhone. Pictures of small blue caterpillar. White, off-white slugs.
I've opened this flower head up, and I could see that there was frass, which is the caterpillar poo, and found this caterpillar here, which was burrowing its head into the seed. You can actually see the seeds there.
Finally did me team caterpillar.
Yeah.
Fantastic.
Let's get a photograph of that.
Yes! Well done. It's a two-pointer.
Yeah.
It is a two-pointer. Yes.
Oh, you're
quality butterfly.
There's still people there that are like that.
Yeah.
The last desperate 2 minutes to see if we can find one more thing. Everyone's running around. Getting a bit desperate, but I think time is up.
Okay. Time's up.
5 o'clock.
Before we go off, can I just say, let's make this clear: we do not discuss our findings with the other team at all.
Absolutely.
It's down to the adjudicators to decide what the situation is.
Yes.
They're going to be looking at what interesting trends we've seen or interesting things we've seen, so that when we do it on live on TV, they're going to say something about butterflies of today.
Yeah.
Like, in fact, we've seen a hell of a lot.
Yeah.
You know,
we have seen a lot.
Yeah, and that's very encouraging. Shows if we get it right, conditions.
I mean, look at the.
But you, thank you, Neil. You did really well.
Well, thank
you.
Yeah,
really well. Well done.
You planned a great.
Yeah.
Well, I think we all deserve a pat on the back.
We do. Let's pat the man next to us on the back.
Form a circle.
Come on, pat this person. You didn't get a pat.
I think that was a good performance.
It was.
You're in with the enemy.
Robot, come to the front, boys.
So the website, if you want to find out all about the butterflies, is bigbutterflycount.org. Now we do have the adjudicators here, Debbie Tan. Debbie, who's won the competition?
We've checked the results on points. I can tell you it was a draw. Team Wood White got two more species, so they are the winners.
I think everyone's had a blast today. It's been absolutely great. I mean, it's been like a furnace out there, but it has been good fun. We've seen loads of stuff, and that was a proper surprise.
Yeah.
I really thought you guys had got it. I really thought you got us on the line there. So yeah, really, really pleased with that.
How important is it to track butterflies?
Well, it's really important. It's good for the soul, for a start, and what a better thing to do on a day like today. But also, just being aware of what butterflies are doing, where they are, and how they're doing, gives us so many clues about the state of the countryside.
Brilliant, thank you very much for joining us. But it certainly is perfect weather for butterfly hunting. Back to you in the studio.
Yeah!
All you need is love and understanding. And ring the bell and let the people know. We're so happy and we're celebrating. Let your feelings show. Love is all. Yes, love is all. Let's go!
Thank you.